According to The Economist, data has replaced oil as the world's most valuable resource. Data can help us achieve tremendous things as individuals, as businesses, and as a society. But to extract the best value from data, you need to be using the best techniques and the best technology. I'm with IBM's Ann-Elise Delbecq to find out how we can tap the true potential of data. We have heard for the last few years now about this untapped potential of data. Is there still potential left to tap?
So I would definitely say that companies have started to analyze their data, but we still have a long way to go. Companies, they do understand that they need to rely more and more on data rather than gut feeling to get new opportunities. But we do generate a lot of data around the world, and a lot of it remains untapped and not analyzed. So I think we're in transitioning as we speak.
Why aren't companies getting all of the value that they want out of their data? What's the problem?
I think it's a combination of factors. So first of all, there is weak decision making because of biased insights, and often that's because there's not one single version of the truth. That's because they cannot access data sources, or they can simply not trust their data sources. Second, there is also this complexity that is coming from the volume of the data, the speed at which data is generated, different data sources, and also the different types of data, whether it's structured or unstructured. And then we also have this really growing cost and risk of protecting and managing data. So I think really companies need to create a data-driven culture to reap the benefits of data and analytics.
What do you mean by data-driven culture, and how can companies go about creating one?
So I think first of all, they need to see their data as a strategic asset, and they should also change a little bit their approach to managing data. So I would really start with an open information architecture so that teams are freed up from the inhibitors to get to that culture. And then you need really this one single version of the truth. You can do that by integrating, cataloging, and protecting your data. And once you have that one single version of the truth, you can really infuse everything with data science and deep analytics. And that's how you will get new insights that you never had seen before. And that's how you will make better decisions and really drive change. And then we want to get to artificial intelligence. That's where you really are going to put the analytics that you have and the machine learning. You really implement that so that you really get to that path towards artificial intelligence.
What does that look like in practice? Give me an example of a data-driven culture.
Well, for example, companies in the financial sector that really wanted to serve better their customers. So they really infuse machine learning and artificial intelligence in their call center so that they can better serve their customers. But they also added some real-time analytics into their fraud detection and also loan underwritings so that they could really make fast decisions and really be better organized.
Ann-Elise, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thanks for watching. Learn more at ibm.com/analytics. Click through for more interviews with IBM, and please subscribe for more disruptive innovations and transformative insights from theneweconomy.com.